I would like to ask Mr. Raizada, if they are given PRC, what do you think will be the political changes that will occur in Jammu and Kashmir?
There would be no demographically change, number one. There are hardly 2% or 3% of the total population. And you know what I said, Abhishek sitting here is not going to Jammu and Kashmir to claim the employment there. He's not going there to claim the property there. What I'm crying for, those persons who have settled there in 1947, who have settled there in 1957, at your instance, one in the wake of the partition, if those people, a segment of the 5 lakhs, 4 lakhs or whatever is, their kids, fourth and fifth generation have been living there, they have taken birth, constitution prohibits any discrimination on the ground of gender, on the ground of sex, on the ground of residence, etc. So for what you said, it doesn't change because they have been living there. They have been living there. It's not that they left there at a cutoff date and they want to go back and create a situation. So therefore, what I'm saying that I'm not for the rest of the country. I'm not myself. I'm not representing. But my brothers are crying there. Kids are saying there. Radhika Gill is symbolizing his class. So they are saying, what for we have taken birth in the country? So these persons are not being, I tell you, in 2002, there was a committee, Vadhva committee. So therein, it was debated what to give, not to give. The total discourse in the committee is one-sided. Nobody is bothering about them because they are not in numbers. So right to vote has also been curtailed. I did not discuss it because a 35A is a different subject. There are civil rights. So political rights, I could not discuss because I have studies on that aspect also. But the issue is that, you know, right to vote triggers everything. The moment you have the right to vote, you can change the mindset of a person. The fellow will be coming, he'll get a boot from you that you are talking about me, that I should not get right. So therefore, this is circular theory. Here, you deny property right. A permanent resident will purchase property only. Here, whosoever does not have the property will not have a right to vote. So it's a circle, a vicious circle they have created. So that's what I'm saying. It's not a game. It's a game of people who feel that their regional interest, it is the regional parties. I'm sorry. No national party has taken a stand other than one political party. No national party has taken a stand and with reasons. They say whatever has been accorded in Delhi Agreement 1952, it should be respected. You please tell me where it 1952 Delhi Agreement says that this is. Because it was between two political leaders, therefore they will suffer. Even if it is there, it is not there. So I am saying, but I have not said anything political party. I said political is political discourse by stakeholders. So they are, I am very guarded on it. I don't want any political discussion on it. But this political stakeholders enforcing a constitutional discourse in relation to Jammu and Kashmir must at least discuss threadbare and let they come to a common platform to move ahead. That's why I said, I am not saying that there is a fight between minority and majorities. You can't. But they try to understand those persons, those kids, how you can expect that 3% of the population without education opportunity, without employment opportunity, the state can progress. You have a 5% of the population in the slums. So you can't progress. That's what I'm saying.